Hello everyone, welcome to JS Podcast. Today we are going to discuss about Bollgard 1 and Bollgard 2, which is a genetically modified transgenic cotton and it provides control and protection against a wide range of insect pests in the cotton cultivation. So today we will discuss about BT cotton in detail. But first of all, let's see what are the topics that we are going to cover in this section. So first one, we will understand briefly about cotton and why it is important as a commercial crop. Second one, we will discuss about the various problems of insect pest in the cotton cultivation. Third one, we will understand why BT cotton is needed to control the damage caused by insects and also understand its mechanism to control the insect from damaging the cotton crop. Now fourth one, we will talk about first generation BT cotton, that is Bollgard 1, and second generation BT cotton, that is Bollgard 2. And finally, we will analyze the overall advantages of the BT cotton. So let's begin. Now, if we talk about cotton, it is the most important commercial crop of India as it contributes around 75% of raw material requirements of the textile industry. Also, India has the largest area under cotton cultivation, which is about 41% of the world area under the cotton cultivation. That is approximately around 13.5 million hectares. And in India, Gujarat is the leading cotton growing state, followed by the Maharashtra. So cotton plays an important role in the Indian economy as the country's textile industry is predominantly cotton based, and also India is one of the largest producer as well as the exporter of the cotton. So in this way, cotton is an important crop for India. Now, as we know that cotton is one of the most important commercial crop in India and it has many advantages, but on the other hand, cotton is also susceptible to a wide range of insect pests which cause serious damage to the crop. Generally, cotton is attacked by several insect and pests which may be classified into sap-sucking insects such as aphids, jassids and the whitefly, or the other insects such as bollworms, leaf-eating caterpillars, which usually feeds on the cotton balls. Now, to control damage caused by these insect pests, several strategies are advocated, such as the use of genetic resistance to the insect pest, which is effective in preventing the crop damage. Likewise, integrated pest management is an effective approach to the pest control and prevention. Also, the insecticide resistance system management is another method to monitor, control and prevent the insect pests. Now, the pest control methods like integrated pest management and insecticide resistant management strategy is only effective and available against the sap-sucking pests such as jassids, whitefly, etc. But such kind of known resistance and control is not available against the bollworms. So bollworms are harmful and difficult to control than the other pests because they feed inside the cotton balls and destroy them. And the common sign of their infestation or accumulation in the plant include this shedding of flower buds in the cotton, deformation of the flower, reduction in the lint development, that is reduction in the white fluffy cotton balls, and the destruction of the seeds. So these are some of the symptoms of the presence of bollworms in the cotton plant. Now here comes the main role of BT cotton. So to control the damage caused by the bollworms, BT cotton technology is found to be one of the best strategies. And BT cotton is produced by cloning and transferring of the gene encoding the toxin crystal protein called as CRI1EC from the soil bacterium Bacillus thuringiensis. So BT cotton is created through the addition of genes encoding toxin crystals, that is CRI1EC, into the normal cotton by the process of genetic engineering to make the plant resistant to the cotton bollworms. Now let's see the mechanism of BT cotton or how it works against the bollworms. So when the genetically modified BT cotton is consumed by the insects or bollworms, the inactive protein that is CRI1AC is converted to its active toxic form, which in turn destroys the gut of the insect. And after that, this crystalline toxin enters and dissolves in the body cavity of the insects, and due to blood poisoning, the insects eventually dies. So in this way, BT cotton works against the bollworms. Now let's discuss the features and advantages of BollGuard 1 and BollGuard 2. But before moving to that section, let's talk about little history behind the BT cotton. So BT cotton was first approved for its commercial use in 1995 in the United States. And if we talk about India, in year 2002, a joint venture between Monsanto and the Maharashtra Hybrid Seed Corporation introduced BT cotton for the first time to India. And in 2011, India grew the larger genetically modified cotton crop at 10.6 billion hectares capacity. And by 2014, 95% of cotton grew in India was genetically modified. Okay, now let's analyze the comparative feature and benefits of BollGuard 1 and 2. So in BollGuard 1, the most prevalent BT gene was first incorporated into a cotton plant by company Monsanto, which later named it as BollGuard cotton or the first generation BT cotton. On the other hand, in order to provide more inbuilt protection for cotton against the destructive bollworm, the second generation BT cotton was introduced, which is called as BollGuard 2, and it is more superior than the first generation BT cotton. Next feature of BollGuard 1 is that it contains only one gene called as CRI1AC, whereas the new BollGuard 2 contains both the crystal proteins, that is CRI1AC and CRI2AB. Now, if we see the benefits, BollGuard 1 helps in the reduction of farmers' exposure to various pesticides and promotes eco-friendly environment. Also, it is an labor-saving technology due to the elimination of insecticidal sprays. Whereas BollGuard 2 provides much improved protection and control over wide variety of insects, and it also increases yield of cotton due to the effective control of the pests. So this is comparative analysis between BollGuard 1 and 2. Let's move on to discuss the overall advantages of BT cotton. So first one is BT cotton is good for the environment because BT cotton cultivars exhibited excellent control of the bollworms and reduced the impact of insecticides to create an eco-friendly environment without compromising yield or production. And BT cotton is also helpful in the reduction of pesticides, hence less air pollution and improved safety to the farm workers. Now, second one, that is reduced bollworm damage and reduction in insecticide sprays. So large scale of BT cotton has resulted in the significant reduction of insecticide use by 40 to 60% in the cotton fields. And apart from causing a reduction in the usage of insecticides all over the world, BT cotton has significantly contributed to the enhanced better yield and production of cotton. Third one is improved economic outlook for the cotton industry. So BT cotton means an opportunity to grow cotton in new areas or restart the industry in the areas that earlier had to abandon cotton due to the insect pressure. So in this way, BT cotton is also good for the economic growth of the country. So these are some of the advantages of BT cotton. Now let's move on to discuss a question which has been asked in CSE prelims. So the question is, BollGuard 1 and BollGuard 2 technologies are mentioned in the context of So here four options are given. Now let's analyze option number A. So here clonal propagation is the production of the identical plants from the vegetative parts of the parent plants like stems, roots, leaf, etc. So it is not genetically modified process. Hence option A is incorrect. Now let's see option number B. So as we have already discussed, BT cotton is a genetically modified pest resistant cotton plant. So yes, this option is correct one. Now let's see option number C. So plant growth substances are these certain compounds such as auxins, cytokinin, etc., which is responsible for the regulation of growth and maturity in the plants. So this option is also incorrect. Now let's analyze option number D. So here biofertilizers are the natural microbes, for example, rhizobium, that enhances the plant nutrition by increasing nutrient availability in the soil. So this option is also incorrect. Now the correct answer for this question is option number B, that is genetically modified plant. Now, if you have any doubt regarding this question or you have any suggestions regarding this whole topic, please write it in the comment section. Also, you can download the PDF for the same from the description box and stay tuned with us for such more interesting GS topics. Till then, thank you everyone and have a nice day.